Steve Dotto here. How the heck you doing this fine day? Me? I'm like a kid in a candy store with a new toy that I get to tell you about today. The new toy is called Appear.im, and it's a social conferencing tool for private groups. I've been talking a lot about Blab, a social conferencing tool for broadcast, for public groups. But Blab has one serious limitation, is you can't create a private group. So you can't use it for training or for something which you basically don't want a bunch of outsiders to be involved in, for private conversations. Well, Appear.im is very similar to Blab in almost all aspects, except it's not public, it's private. You can actually even close off your room and make it completely private so you can have intimate conversations with coworkers or people you're consulting with. You can do small trainings and tutorials up to 8 people at a time. And currently, it's free. I think you're gonna wanna see it today on Dotto Tech. I am really impressed by some of the steps that we're taking in the space of in video space in the online world. Certainly Blab has been a revelation for me, and I have to give props to my good buddy Todd Maffin, who first introduced me to Appear.im. At first blush, this tool looks very similar to a Skype-like tool where we can do simple video conferencing, but it's far more accessible than Skype. We don't need a dedicated app in order to use it. We can work right within our browser. It's free to use, and it's easy to configure up to 8 people in a room at a time. Now, I think 8 is a lot, but certainly for 2- and 3-person conversations, the sort of thing you'll typically have with a small group of your team members, it is outstanding. And it has some wonderful integrations in other tools which I'm working with, namely Slack, which I'm going to show you in a minute. But I think we better just dive in and show you how it works. It's free to use, and you don't even have to sign up or anything. You could just go and you can start a room. You go to appear.im and you create a room. Now, this will open my room because I have actually registered it and claimed this room to be able to use it over and over again. But the room is basically where we start a video conference. Now, you're going to lose my feed from the normal, screencast feed because Appear is going to take over the feed. So we're going to be having to do this part of the demo here from within the interface itself. But you can now use this tool, which, as I say, is free. You can customize the background if you want to do some branding. You can lock the room so that people can't find it from the outside. And you can invite people in. Now, I've got several people who I've dealt with on a regular basis on this, so I can just send them a quick little notification here and ask Mike to join us in the room. You can also send it as a messenger, Facebook Messenger, or a text message if you've got them in your address book in that way there. So actually, let's send Mike a messenger one. I haven't done that before. Facebook Messenger, there it is. Oh, enter the friends or groups. There's Mike as well. Let's invite him there. I haven't done that before. I've invited him in several locations now. Now, it takes a second because it's going through email for Mike to come in. Oh, there it is. Just took a few seconds. And you see Mike is now connected. Hey, Mike, how did you get that message? Because I also sent it to you on Facebook.
It was Facebook, actually. I happened to be on Facebook.
And it was faster. Because yeah. There is, if you notice at the top of this, there's actually the option to be able to invite people in by Facebook and by SMS as well.
Yep. Yeah.
So this is Mike Vardy. For those of you who might not know, Mike works with me on a variety of different productivity projects. And isn't this Appear.im just the cat's meow?
It is. I used it the other day with three of the productivityist team members, one of which was on mobile. So it was really cool to see the way they arranged the windows, and I could screen share with them. It was really, really cool. And I mean, thanks for introducing it to me.
Do you have anything up? You can do a quick screen share so we can see what the screen share looks like from our side.
Hold on a second. Let me just this.
While you're doing that, the screen sharing tool comes down here. You hover your mouse over top of the window, the active window, and that allows screen share. So I'm going to let Mike share the screen with us so we can see the size. The screen is not quite full screen, but it's actually not too bad. Oh, it's interesting. There we go. So
that's just byword. That's just one part of my screen. Like, that's a specific, like, so like with Chrome, you can share part of it, or I can share the whole, like if I share everything.
So you shared the app there as opposed to, see, now I'm getting your widescreen format.
Yeah.
And we're getting the tunneling, but you can see that we've got Mike's computer screen here being shared. So not quite full screen. So not as perfect as, say, a Skype for doing screen sharing, but still pretty darn functional.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely. It's really cool. I like I like the fact that you can chat in the middle and all that stuff, and you can kick people out, which you could do at any time, or ban them if you want.
That's right. So what I'm going to get you to do, Mike, is I'm going to get you to exit again, and I'm going to show the audience a slightly different way that we can get into these calls, because we're going to look at the Slack integration, which is just brilliant.
Okay.
Okay, so head on out. So here, what I'm going to do is I'm just going to close this room down, and when I do that, everything should pop back over to having me now because the session is shut down. So I'm now back in my normal screencasting software. I know we're jumping back and forth here. But I'm going to open up my Slack installation here. And I've got a variety of different groups I work with here in Slack. Now, if you haven't checked out our Slack demo, I am so impressed with Slack as a communications manager. It's a unified communications tool that we use for all of our different projects now. Our whole team uses it. But Slack allows something called integrations, where you can bring outside apps and make them work within Slack. So Appear is a Slack integration. So you can go through what I just did as far as launching the browser and inviting people into the room through the browser interface, or if you're in Slack, you can go /, which brings up all of the different commands, and you can see the top command I have is Appear. If I type in Appear and then a space, and then name the room that I want to invite people to, I've just created the video conference right here within Slack called Dotto Tech, and I click on that, and Mike gets that notification as an instant message happening within the Slack environment, and anybody else that was in that channel would do it as well. And now Mike's come back in because he's seen that notification appear in Slack. This, to me, blew my mind. I thought this was a good tool before I saw this integration with Slack. And as soon as I saw this integration with Slack, Mike, I went, boom, this is awesome.
Yeah, it's pretty cool. So you can actually, if you're in the middle of a Slack conversation, you're like, you know what, let's just chat about it. You can actually do it.
Exactly. Now, while we're here, because I didn't show you the screen sharing options from our side, well, this is the screen sharing options that we just went through with Mike. So we can show the entire screen, which he showed us at the end, or you can show just an application, which seems to be a slightly higher resolution and might be a little bit more efficient for some trainings, Mike, as you kind of go ahead. Yeah, you're doing it again. You're just laying it, and I can actually read that quite comfortably. So yeah, that's pretty cool.
That's my text editor, and then if I do the whole screen.
Yeah, once again.
Then you'll get the tunneling.
Yeah, we did that. And that's all fine. But I was just showing them from my side here, or from our side, what it looks like when you do it. Now, before you leave, I'm actually going to enter the room one more time. And what I'm doing now is I'm bringing up the smartphone, and I'm bringing up the Appear app in the smartphone. And I'm typing in the name of the room. I'm wondering, I'm going to plug my headset in just in case we get audio feedback from it. There we go. And I'm going to start. And there I am. Are you ready for this, folks? There it is.
There it is.
There we are, there we joining. Are
joining. A little bit of echo.
Let me think. How can I install this? Doesn't matter, does it? A little bit of echo is okay because of you. But isn't that amazing?
A little bit of echo is okay because of you. But isn't that amazing? A little bit of echo is okay
because of you. Oh, there. Now I muted it, so that's good. Isn't that, to me, is just phenomenal that we have the ability to be able to, it looked like I was picking my nose, that we have the ability to bring in by mobile as well as by desktop. And the app is running a little bit jerky right now. Maybe it's kind of crushing my bandwidth because of everything that's going on. And I know we've got some other things going on in the other room. But it gives you a real good feel for how it all pulls together, doesn't it?
Mm-hmm, absolutely. You can have here.
Sorry?
8 people.
Yes, you can have up to 8 people. Now, how do I leave the room here? Let's do it this way. I'm not sure how you leave the room. I haven't used the mobile app enough. There it is. So it's gone. So thanks so much, Mike. I'm going to wrap things up here, but thanks for helping out.
No problem. Glad to help.
Okay, talk to you later. So, folks, that is Appear.in, a whole new breed of social conferencing tools. Up to 8 people. Free to use currently. I think it is well worth checking out. And I hope you found today's video to be well worth spending time with. There are 3 ways to stay in touch with us here on Dotto Tech. The first is please subscribe to our channel. The second is I encourage you to subscribe to our newsletter. That way you'll hear about our live events, tutorials, and trainings. And finally, Dotto Tech is a community-funded site through the support of our friends at Patreon. If you'd like to find out what's involved in being a patron of Dotto Tech, what benefits and perks there are for you, and what it gives us here on Dotto Tech, I would encourage you to drop by our Patreon page and have a look. Until next time, I am Steve Dotto. Special thanks to Mike Vardy. Have fun storming a castle.